I'm fostering a dog that has bit a person before and was severely abused and beat daily. Do you have any advice? I've rehabilitated my own dog through your free content.
So tons of advice. But number one, how do you know it was abused and beat daily? Do you have video proof? Do you have video proof that it was beat daily? Have you seen the video of it being beaten? And I only say this because it could be a made up story and it just keeps getting duplicated. So this is what I want you to do. Yazzarino 101. I never want you to repeat that again. Got it? I want you to wipe that phrase out of your description of that dog. It's gone. So you've got a dog that's what? Fearful. You have a dog that's nervous. You've got a dog that's not obedient. You've got a dog that has bitten. But I don't want you to ever repeat that it was abused ever again. Wipe it clean. That memory is gone. Because if you keep holding on to that, it will affect your success of rehabbing the dog. So what do? Put the dog through my program, just like you did with your other dogs. Next. We're live.
Are we?
Yeah, we're live. Jump on in. Hey, everybody. How are you? How's everybody doing? Welcome to the show. Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, the What Would Jeff Do Dog Training Q&A. What's the day of the week today? Wednesday?
Monday.
Monday night. We start the show at 9 p.m. because of family activities, which includes right now on Mondays, it's dance, ballet.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of ballet going on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
So Linda's in the house. Linda's our dedicated Monday person. Linda's my wife, so there's no confusion. A couple of people have been like, they've made a couple of things. They'll get my wife wrong. Or
really, who could be your wife besides me?
My other co-host. Or they'll mention like, someone will like yell at me like, would you talk like that to your wife? And I'm like, do you mean the woman sitting right next to me? It's like, she's been with me for 18 years. I think she sort of knows. All right. Anyway. If you're brand new to my world, welcome. Welcome to the show. Everybody on Spotify, SoundCloud, on Google, on iHeartRadio, on iTunes, and any other podcasting sound platform, welcome. I really, really treasure all of you. And then obviously, if you're watching this on YouTube Live, thank you. And thank you for the contribution and the great questions. If you're watching the replay, again, welcome. And I'm doing this about three times a week. And then I also do, I'm an Instagram AMA on Mondays. So there's a lot of different ways that, and then on my Patreon channel all week long, I do Q&As as well. What I have is a dog training company up in Providence, Rhode Island. And I personally travel the world doing seminars. In fact, in 2019, it looks like I'm scheduled for about 20 seminars in 2019, which is pretty, pretty powerful. Right now, I think probably the most seminars any dog trainer is doing right now, all over the world. I'm still looking for locations. In fact, we just booked San Francisco. We're just this week alone, we launched San Francisco, Reno, and North Carolina. I think that's the other one that we did. We just launched San Francisco yesterday. But I specialize, and our company specializes in aggression rehab, behavior modification. We're really, really good at stopping unwanted behaviors. Obviously, like any dog trainer out there, we can train dogs to do stuff. So all your basic commands, sit down, place, recall, heal. Not many dog trainers work with aggression. Not many dog trainers do behavior modification. Not many dog trainers actually can stop unwanted behaviors. That's just not what most dog trainers do. So when you're looking for a dog trainer, also, we are pet dog trainers. Family pet dog trainers. And I think that's important because when you're looking for a dog trainer, like, I mean, nothing against canine officers. I'm friendly with many canine cops, but they're not going to help you with your pet dog, most likely. An agility trainer is not going to help you with your pet dog. A trick trainer is not going to help you with your pet dog. So it's important, you know, competition obedience, all that stuff is different. It's all different. It all taps into different drives, different training methodologies. There's a lot of different things. So you want to find a pet dog trainer. You'll be able to ask a question at the bottom of your screen. You can ask a question where it says, say something. You just type in your question. And then at the bottom below that, there's a little dollar sign. The dollar sign is for super chats. We try to get through all the questions, but if you do a super chat, your question goes right to the top right away. And we'll answer that question. At least the ones that I just found out that are $5 or more. Did you know that? Sometimes we don't get notified of a question. That's because it's under $5. I had no idea. Oh, okay. Yeah, I had no idea. So we don't see that until later in the stream. That money gets used for date night. This week we did, what did we do this week?
That was last week. This week is this
week. Oh, we haven't gone out yet. Yeah, tomorrow night we're going out.
Last week we went to the movies.
Went to the movies in the Cheesecake Factory. We did that. And then we also took Chris and Sandy out. Mm-hmm. We'll be actually paying for that for the next month. So that was an expensive one. We took them out to Los Andes. And then tomorrow night we're going out somewhere. We don't know where yet, though. Nowhere. Let's go. We'll figure it out, though. And just follow us on Instagram stories. If you don't follow us on Instagram stories, it's a lot of fun. So let's just jump right into the show. We've got a 90-minute show. And what? We do a 90-minute show.
We don't do a 90-minute show on Mondays.
Well, then you better freaking start asking questions. Go.
This one's from Angela. My cousin just got a 4-year-old GSD. The dog chases his tail. What do you suggest? I said correct behavior and start working on place. Before you answer this, though, did you say 90 minutes because you were hoping I wouldn't say anything?
No, I thought I was just thinking we do a 90-minute show.
You and Joelle do a 90-minute show. We do a one-hour show. Okay,
and she's planning to have a conversation about that with me, from what I understand.
What do you mean?
Possibly not doing a 90-minute show. She struggles.
It's a long freaking show.
I want to do a 2-hour show.
But that's your business.
Okay. So forget place. Get yourself a remote collar and you make it suck. You can stop tail chasing and any other OCD behavior in about 3 seconds. You can hear a lot of other stuff to do. It won't work. Use a remote collar. Make it suck. The dog doesn't need more exercise. Now, listen, I'm a huge advocate of exercise. I'm a huge advocate of diet. I feed raw. I'm a huge advocate of training. But when it comes to stopping an unwanted behavior, none of those things are factors. You have to learn how to properly apply punishments. We're going to use the word punishment a lot on this show because everybody wants me to stop stuff. You can't use a reward to stop an unwanted behavior. We don't train alternative behaviors. We don't redirect. We stop the unwanted behavior. Next.
This next one's from Angie B. Ordered mini educator, T302, 2 dogs. Can't wait to get them on it.
Awesome. Next.
Robert, have you tried the Ecollar Technologies new micro? If so, would you recommend it for a 7-pound dog?
Yeah, they're good because you can take the box and go from this way to this way, and you can just put the strap through differently. It's only about 25% smaller. Next.
Angie, switching from Garmin Sport Pro 70.
That's a good item. You know, the Garmin Sport Pro is good, but, you know, you can do that. I believe that goes up to 3 dogs, but that's fine. No problem. Next.
This one's from Angela. By the way, my cousin lives out of state, and I've been spamming him with your YouTube videos.
Awesome. Thank you.
Also, I just wanted to say hi and ask you when you will be doing trivia.
I have no idea when we're going to be doing trivia at all. That was just an idea.
What's the trivia?
Just like, because, you know, I have all these, like, catchphrases and slogans, and I tell stories about my childhood and about us and like whatever. Yeah,
leave me out of it.
Okay. But so we thought maybe do a trivia night. Next.
Angela says, Linda, your hair is gorgeous.
Yeah.
Thank you.
It really looks
good. For some reason, right here is not doing what I want it to.
I got a stapler. Next.
Lindsay.
Hey, Lindsay.
Hi, Jeff and Linda.
How are you?
Melanie, want to use Ecollar to improve recall? Dog is trained to wireless boundary. You mentioned introducing e-collar off property. What does that look like? How many sessions? Don't want to freak her.
I don't know how many sessions because I don't know your skill set and I don't know the dog. We always recommend it, if you have an underground fence, train the dog recall off property. It's not mandatory, but if you have the option, do it. The reason is because underground fence keeps the dog from going through the stem. You want the dog to go through the stem. Next.
Cassie.
Hey, Cassie. Love you.
When working with a one-on-one client that has a dog with overexcitement issues, which would you prioritize, the place command or the structured walk?
None of them. Bonk the dog. Right, Cassie, remember from Elkhart, Indiana? I miss you. Hopefully I'll see you out there again. Make sure you bonk the dog. Eliminate the arousal before you start training anything. Next.
This one's from the Horror Queen. I have a question about my giant Alaskan Malamute. How can I train him not to dig or not to chew up things? He's been in basic obedience training, gets enough exercise and mental stimulation, and he still chews and digs up things. How can I fix this?
Horror Queen, you can run your dog three times as much, give your dog every brain game in the world, and what's the other thing? And teach him 20 more commands. It will never stop digging or chewing, ever. The only way to stop chewing and digging is through the proper application of punishment for those two things. Get yourself a remote collar. Dog's outside. You're inside. Have the remote collar on the highest setting. With your Malamute, make sure you've got the thick fur contact points, long ones. Make sure it's snug. Use Ecollar or Dogtra. Don't go cheap. It's worth it. Just give up some of your vices for a month. Then what I want you to do, when the dog starts digging, you hold the button down for 3 seconds. You make it suck to dig. That's how you stop it. All this other bullshit that you hear, fill the hole with water. What? So your dog gets muddy? Fill the hole with shit. So your dog gets muddy and shitty? First of all, where does the shit come from? Whose shit is it? That's the stupidest. These are things that people do.
Whose shit is it?
Yeah, what do you do? Hey, excuse me. Let's like send a mass email out to all the neighbors. Do you guys mind coming over here and taking a big shit in this hole in my backyard? Like, what? Oh, yeah, bring your own toilet paper too. No, what? Yeah, for pizza and beer? Probably could get a couple of neighbors, actually. We got neighbors that would actually do that. So, but no, you do that. Chewing, set up a nanny cam, put the stuff out, watch your dog. They go to chew something, make it suck to chew. Oh, no, have lots of chew toys. Don't know. My dogs don't have any chew toys. I'm not against chewing, but no. Got it? Next.
All right. Bad Shody. Hi there. I have a one-year-old lab and an English Mastiff that is 6 months old. They love to play with each other in the house, but I would like to stop them from getting too excited. What can I do?
Stop letting them play in the house. That's a bad habit to do. You've got a lab and a Mastiff playing in your house? Unless you've got a 16,000 square foot house, I don't recommend it. And even then, why the fuck would you want your dogs to ruin a nice house? Outside. That's what outside is for. No indoor play. And then also make sure they stop on command. If you're going to get your dogs all jacked up, you better be able to get them down, meaning enough. Boom, they stop. Next.
This one's from Zachary.
Hey, Zachary.
Training 3 times a day with my dog's kibble has been the best advice. At 10 weeks, he's crushing all of the basic commands. I can't wait to solidify it and continue working with him as he matures.
Zach, man, you're fucking killing it. Bam. Fist bumps for Zach, guys. Next.
Dr.
Trauma.
Trauma. Oh, yeah. Hey, yo.
Hey, yo, yo. Next.
Melissa says, hi, Jeff.
Hey, Linda. Melissa. Hey, good Melissa. To have you here, hon. Next.
Susan. Camo cowers when I use the mini educator, even on level 4. What to do?
Don't worry. It's not the level. I've got a dog that the punishment level is level 4. It's not the level. You do it with food. Introduce it with food. Have a leash on the dog, and it could be the way you're presenting it to the dog. Next.
Tiffany. Hey, hi, Tiffany. Guys. On a structured walk every now and again, shit happens. Does this happen on your structured walks? I'm walking 4 dogs. Make them potty beforehand, but it happens.
What are you talking about? Dogs take a dump on a walk? Tiffany, no shit. I mean, yes, shit.
No, there is shit.
Like, of course they do. They're dogs. Come on. Next, put a fucking cork in their assholes. Don't do that, though. They'll fucking find corks. They'll be all over the streets of Cleveland. Next.
That's just weird. Next. Karen. Hi, Jeff and Linda. Nice to see you back, Linda.
Yeah, she was never gone. She just does Mondays. Next, we had to renegotiate her contract. Next.
Natalie. Want to practice proofing in public with my dog. Work on sit and down stays or structured walking and obedience. Do correction with both. Getting mini educator soon.
Yes. To answer your question, do it all. Next.
Okay. Dr. Trauma. How frequent should you correct for unacceptable behavior in the crate? It seems like I have to do it every 3 seconds. Should I correct, then give him a few minutes to calm down, or correct every outburst?
Every single outburst. You're not correcting. You're nagging. You're nagging. It's not a correction unless it stops. You're nagging. Next.
Natalie, speaking of bonking, in home, my dog runs when I pick up Bonker. I keep it on me, but runs as soon as I lift it. Do I follow him or give him a command or catch him? I'm adding Ecollar shortly to interrupt.
Definitely don't call him over to you and bonk him. You'll destroy recall. All right. Why isn't your dog on a leash? Got it? Unless your dog's underneath voice control, right? And don't let your dog see you have the bonker. You got to be more stealth-like. But remote collar will help. You shouldn't have to bonk that much, by the way, guys. Next.
Vincent. Hello, Jeff and Linda. Have been missing the last couple shows. I need to go back and catch up. What kind of muzzle would you recommend for a full-grown GSD, metal wire or leather?
Depending on what the application is. If you just need a, I mean, if you're working the dog, I mean, if it's doing like muzzle fighting, that's one thing. You know what I mean? But a basic Baskerville, which is actually a plastic composite, I would get a Baskerville. You'll probably need a size 4 or 5, and you can get them on Amazon. Next.
Susan says, by the way, I don't mean to chastise your friends. He just seemed to be bad talking your speed walk.
Susan, Sean and I go back way back. You need to put that into perspective. Don't be so quick on the gun. Don't be so quick on the gun. You follow us. Sean O'Shea from The Good Dog has got probably the best content out there on dog training and life right now. Don't worry about me. I can take care of myself. Me and Sean are buddies. Like, we travel the world together. Next.
Leanne.
And you did chastise him. Send him donuts.
Don't send him anything. Play fair, motherfucker.
Send him donuts. Next.
I'm renegotiating my contract.
Leanne.
Had someone run up to me and start petting my dog tonight. I pulled my dog away. Girl proceeded to call me an F&B. Remembered your advice and didn't engage, walked away, and enjoyed my night.
Good. Could have pushed her to the ground, too.
Oh, my God.
So, Leanne, typical example, guys. This person doesn't like dogs. Had someone run up to me and start petting my dog tonight. I pulled my dog away. Girl proceeded to call her a fucking bitch.
I was trying to be a little...
It's really funny how the biggest verbal abusers... This is going to sound sexist as fuck, but I really don't care. Are female. There's a friend of mine. Her name is Julie. There was a wonderful video of her walking her client's dogs in Home Depot, in Lowe's, which is dog friendly. They love her there. They want her there. And they allow dogs. It was posted on a Facebook group. Someone else posted it there. 30 to 40 hateful comments. Not about the remote collar, not about the prong collar, but about how rude she was for walking her dog in Lowe's. 100%. Ladies, don't take this the wrong way. 90% of my clientele is female. I might alienate the fuck out of my whole clientele right now. 100% of the bashing was from females. Female on female online bullying is out of control. I'm fully aware of male assholery. I'm fully aware of male on female violence. I'm very in tune with domestic violence and rape. I've worked hard and long on different things privately, not me raping or me being domestically violent. What I'm saying is organizations, donating money, doing fundraisers. But this constant, hourly, and daily bashing of females by other females is out of control. It really is out of control. So, ladies, enough already. Seriously, enough. Literally, like you're like I'm amazed by it. I'm totally blown away by it. I mean, I can really get into deep detail about like the whole psychological profile of what's going on out there and how it's affecting society. But I won't, because I don't want to go down that road on this show. And I often want to freaking write about it, but it's so possibly alienating. But I think I might have to, because it is horrific. Most of my colleagues are female trainers. The amount of abuse that they are getting online from 99% females is incredibly scary. It is harmful. It needs to stop. Next.
Oh, you got a top chat.
Lil Mama Rudd. Hey, Jeff and Linda. Rebecca from Cold Hours, Canada here. Day 5 of zero reactivity. A new happy focused dog off leash heel with 180s today. Nice. Saw a car, no problem. Yeah. Next Skype in a month rather than 2 weeks. So helpful for your help. Motherfucking Rebecca. She's the one that lives out in the middle of nowhere. Mm. Literally, like, you need a four-wheeler, like, everywhere. Like, a snowmobile just to, like, get everywhere.
I would cry.
I would love it. Next. Proud of you. We did Leanne, Tammy.
Tammy.
Yes.
How to correct GSD for freaking out when someone else takes the leash, remote collar, and prong being used.
You can do a bonker. The other person has to do the punishing. They have to know how to apply punishment for arousal. Remote collar or bonker is the best way to shut that down. Next.
Horror Queen, thank you. I really appreciate that advice.
You're welcome.
Jillian, I'm puppy sitting a 10-week golden. It's great duration work for my one-and-a-half-year-old GSD. I'm struggling with him breaking place when I use commands with the pup. Example, let's go. I correct. Any other suggestions?
Hold on here. Who's breaking command? The 10-week-old puppy? Oh, when use the commands with the pup. Oh, yeah, your German Shepherd. That's a whole different. That's the thing. It's like you've only told your like the commands have only been towards your dog. So start doing name of dog command, and then correct your dog for breaking the command when you talk to another dog. You literally are almost like back in kindergarten again. Next.
Horror Queen says, I'm going to order an e-collar now.
Awesome.
Next. Annie. Hi, Jeff. Hoping you'll be back at Redmark in Texas next year.
They might have. They're trying to sell the place. They're trying to retire, so probably not. Next.
Angela, are you supposed to introduce the e-collar to the dog before applying corrections?
Depends on what you wanted to do. If somebody calls me up and says, Jeff, my dog is counter surfing, stop. Okay, put the e-collar on and stop it. Next.
Wait, Tammy said you skipped me, but I don't think we did.
That's the next question. I'll look.
Okay. Natalie, fair enough on bonking. I don't call him back. Sometimes put him in downstay to calm him and then start over with behavior. Don't bonk often, just with barking. Is it okay to downstay until calm?
Yes. Tammy, we didn't skip you. That's the one about a German Shepherd freaking out when someone else takes the leash. And I just said, you have to bonk the dog or remote collar the dog. Next.
Natalie, also, yup, got yelled at the females, but the most by females when walking with prong.
Yep.
We've got another top chat.
Another top chat for $9.99 from Liz. $9.99 known question. If you got a question, ask Liz. Sometimes people get a little bit confused. You might be just throwing cash our way for date night. Thank you.
Thank you. Chiba. Jeff, I've seen you use a dominant dog collar in some of your older videos. Do you still use those? In what cases would you recommend those?
We use them all the time. Every dog or human aggressive dog, and then high level leash reactivity. Next.
Okay. Liz had a bad escape today. Loose racing Mal chasing bird headed to 2-lane highway. E-collar on, corrected high, and he turned back instantly. So thankful for you guys.
Liz, fucking awesome. Next. Have that finger on that button at all times.
You ready?
Yep. Next.
Sorry. Toby. How can I teach my dog basic commands if she isn't food or toy driven?
Well, we don't use toys. We're family pet trainers, so we don't use toys. It's not practical. Don't let the dog eat out of a bowl. So if the dog eats one cup or two cups a day or three cups a day, whatever it is, you might be over. Most people overfeed the dog. So only feed through training. Your dog will work for food. We're food trainers. Only feed through training. Don't let them eat out of a bowl. You work, you eat. Next.
Lil Mama Mud, can I send you a selfie of my dog and I on a cold arse walk? Show Linda. She probably will laugh.
Yeah, Jeff at Solid Canine Training. Jeff at SolidCanineTraining.com. Next.
Horror Queen, have you ever trained a Malamute to become a service dog for mobility disabilities?
I don't do service dog work, so no.
Russ, hey, Jeff and Linda, good to see you both.
Hey, Russ, hey. Proud of you, buddy.
Jeff, waiting for that picture post.
Oh, you know what it is? I looked for it. I looked for the photo. Oh, there it is. There it is, right
what
up
are you
there.
Looking for?
My bar mitzvah photo.
Oh, geez.
Yeah.
You should lose that.
Hey, fuck you. Cut the shit.
I'm just joking.
How do you think I financed some of my businesses? Bar mitzvah cash. Read the questions. Okay? That was the beginning.
You're not the boss of me.
That was the beginning of my, that wasn't it. When it was 9 years old was the beginning of my career. My first business purchase was a shoe shine box I made from scratch, actually. It's to shine shoes for a quarter a piece.
Don't you think I already know this?
Yes, next. It's for trivia night.
Tammy has a $4.99 chitty chat.
Thank you for all your help. I really appreciate you. I appreciate you too.
Russ says bar mitzvah money can go a long way.
Yeah, it can.
There's no next.
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
What?
It's a heart attack.
What's going on tonight, guys?
Nope. They didn't like your attitude towards me.
We did. We lost half our viewers. We lost half our viewers when I went on that freaking, when I went on the rant.
Tiffany, do you only board dogs you've pre-trained?
Yeah. We're a private facility. So we do board and play, but only for client dogs, meaning you had to go through our program. We do daycare, small daycare. Yeah, we're probably up to now sometimes 15 dogs. But I don't want to be a daycare. I'm a training facility that offers daycare only for client dogs. The only way you can come in the door is through training. That gets you in. And then you're guaranteed a daycare spot. You're guaranteed a boarding spot. So on Thanksgiving morning, well, maybe not because Thanksgiving we have a skeleton crew. But if you call us up and you say on Thanksgiving morning and say, hey, can I bring my dog there? We have an emergency. Absolutely. If you're one of our clients, always, there's always a spot open for you. If you're one of our clients. Next.
Mackenzie says, hi, Jeff and Linda.
Hey.
Angie B says, yes, attitude.
Yeah, I know. Shoot.
Tommy, I encountered no leash, two pit bulls, two large dogs, and one small dog at trail. All didn't listen. Owner's commands. My friend and I don't see the rest of the question.
Had five small dogs. Friend kicked pit bull to stop large dog. Smart. That's what I would do too. Next.
Is that Elaine?
Elaine, yep.
Hello, guys from Collingwood. LOL, it's getting cold here.
I know. I've seen the pictures.
Sorry to hear that.
I know.
Susan, rant attitude. I thought that was just you.
Rant attitude. I thought that was just you. Yeah.
It is.
It is me. I got lots of rants about society. All positive stuff, though, because the amount of bullying is terrible. I get death threats, guys. I mean, so many of my female trainers get threatened with physical violence from females. I mean, it's terrible. It's really bad. Next.
Patrick. No, Sarah. Jeff, you and Joelle referred to a reference video from Chantel that made you emotional. I couldn't find it.
Well, all my videos make me emotional. I mean, every day. I mean, the testimonials I get from people. Just look up Chantel. It's underneath my testimonial videos. Hopefully it's on my testimonial page. I'll tell you what. Can you, Melissa, can you find Chantel's testimonial? It's the woman from up in the Canada seminar, and maybe put a post of a link there if you've got time. Next.
Patrick, got a dumb question. What is bonking, and will it work on a high-energy Scotch collie?
Patrick, this is a bonker. It's a towel wrapped up tight, secured with two elastics. So, all right. And you literally will say no, and then you no first, and then you literally throw it firmly at the dog. The best time to do it is the beginning sequence of arousal. Next.
Horror Queen, What would you recommend other than an e-collar to help my Malamute to stop pulling on leash? By the way, he does wear a prong collar while we walk, but he does still pull with it.
So, Horror Queen, if he's pulling with it, you're using it wrong. Watch my 180 video. Also apply, you've got a big dog there. You got a big dog. So what you're going to do is you're going to use a lot of compulsion at the beginning. A lot of compulsion. The dog shouldn't be pulling on the collar. That's not the way it's been designed to use. So the leash should always be loose on that. Next.
Cool Sands. How do I find out more about Skype?
Oh, just go to Solid Canine Training, Solid Canine Training, which is my website. And there's a little button for Skypes. And you see all my different fees. Next.
Lady in Green. Are client dogs taught to hold place when doorbell rings, people come in the home? Do dogs need to be on a dog bed away from the door? Is this something that is taught and proof during board and training?
Yeah, absolutely. But you can do it at home. Like, you don't need me for that. But yes, it is. We just did a video. Check out our, where did that video, was that video? That video was on Facebook, I think, over the weekend. Yeah, they just did a video of like 10 dogs in place with doorbell ringing and knocking. That's relatively simple to do. You can do that at home without us, though. Just follow our free videos. Next.
Lil Mama Mud, what is your opinion on snow eating? My pup loves it, but not sure if I should always allow it. And thanks again for your help. We even passed fresh bear tracks. I wasn't worried for once.
Nice, nice. Yellow snow, probably not the best thing to eat. Snow, I mean, we can always get into this whole thing about snow and, you know, how bad, you know, what's in the air and what's in the snow and is there salt in it and chemicals in it and then global warming and all kinds of toxins and all that bullshit. Bottom line is, it ain't the worst thing in the world. I really can care less. Next.
Okay. Tiffany, how long did it take you to get to only take previously trained dogs, struggling with untrained boarding dogs?
From day one. From day one, Tiffany, stop doing it. You'll drive yourself crazy. Literally, don't do it. It's not worth the money. Next.
Tammy, when is the San Francisco seminar? Can't find it on your website.
Go to Jeff Gellman Seminars, jeffgellmanseminars.com. It's there. It's in California. It might not say San Francisco. It says whatever city it's in. It's right. It's 39 miles north of San Francisco. So it's in California, and it's in, I forgot what month. It's there, though. It's there. Next.
Melissa says, Cool Sands, check out Jeff's Patreon for Skype info.
Oh, thanks.
Put the link.
Thanks, Melissa.
Tammy says, I love your rants.
Tammy, thanks. I got lots of them.
Rachel, hey, Jeff, do you get trainer burnout? I am adequate at training dogs, have had many successful client dogs, but I'm getting a new dog and feel completely overwhelmed to train again.
I don't train anymore. I run my company and I travel the world doing seminars. So I'm not doing the daily grind anymore. I've got a staff that does that. I mean, my job is consuming. So the trainer burnout, yeah. I mean, it's really, really common. So, you know, what you might want to do is, I mean, there's a lot of, I mean, I can walk you through it, but yes, it's not uncommon in our industry. Next.
Cool Sand says, cool, thank you.
You're welcome.
Is Kabigski, I never know if I'm saying this right. Hey guys, found a stray a week ago, planned to take to shelter, but she blended in with my pack so well. Have had to use a bonker for jumping and barking, worked like a charm in less than a day.
Yes, it does. Congratulations. Next.
Cool Sands, there's also Skype info on Jeff's website.
Oh, that's right. Yep.
Liz, what would you consider well-trained at 7 months?
I mean, Liz, well, how long have you been working with a dog? You know what I mean? Did you get the dog at 6.5 months? A 7-month-old dog is capable of walking on a leash politely, holding it down in place for 3 to 4 hours easily, coming back when called, not barking, going in a crate. Remember, I'm a pet dog trainer. 7-month-old dog is capable of doing all those things. So, but if you've only been working with a dog for a couple of weeks, it's not going to know that. We're all on a different journey. Next.
Lil Mama Mud, Skype is so worth every penny. I learned calm consistency and confidence are a must.
Nice.
Tommy, is kicking only way to stop dog coming closer?
No, you can use bear spray. Hornet spray. I don't recommend hornet spray, but bear spray, you can use that. Kicking, a hiking stick, throw rocks, sand, dirt. But you have a dog that's, if you've got a dog that is intent on harming you, like, you better freaking be ready to go to war. I mean, there are dogs that are like, they're going to go after whatever dog is with you. I mean, you have to protect yourself and your dog. So don't feel bad about it, guys. Don't feel bad about it. That dog don't feel bad about what it's about to do. Dogs don't feel remorse. So don't worry about it. Next, they're dogs.
This one's from Melanie. My dog acts like an idiot when separated from another dog by a fence or patio door. Fierce and out of control. Open the gate or door and she's on her, peeing on the floor. Bonk, Ecollar.
Yeah, that's because it's just barrier frustration. Just use a remote collar and tell her to shut up. Or bonk, tell her to shut up. Next.
Lil Mama Mud. I don't allow while on leash for the snow eating, just off road. Off leash, no yellow, only the sparkly, LOL.
Yeah, I mean, my dogs eat snow. I could care less. Next.
Jeff's seminar website. Melissa put a link to that.
Thanks.
Patrick, we have 5 indoor cats. How can we curb the what?
To chase curb your one. Dog chasing? Remote collar, make it suck to chase cats. Put the dog into avoidance. That's how you stop cat chasing. You make it suck to chase cats. Simple as that. Next.
IMH Hunt. Hello, guys. I have a lab pit mix. Every time I use the e-collar on him, he shuts down. He won't do any commands. Even when I raise the working level, he knows basic obedience.
Okay. Raising the working level on a dog that's probably shut down might make it worse. Guys, what I want you to do is keep in mind the remote collar is a communication device where you still have to train the dog what it means. The last thing I want, and I say this all the time, the last thing I want anyone to do is just to be pushing buttons for obedience. It's not how the remote collar is supposed to be used. We use a leash, food, the remote, and dog training. And we do hundreds of repetitions. So don't increase the working level. That's not going to help at all. Give more guidance. Keep the dog in kindergarten for a little bit. Next.
Annie says, question. A potential client says their dog was burned by the e-collar at a board and train. Is it possible to do this by stimming too much?
Nope. Can't be done. Nope. It's pressure sores, if anything. Next.
Lorena. Hi, Jeff. Still working with my chow. He went for my face yesterday despite structure and less freedom. Won't touch food until told. All his bites on me have involved food. Doesn't get much affection.
Okay. So the dog shouldn't get any affection, zero. And you have to, okay, you need to Skype for me, number one. I don't care how much, okay, structure is important, obedience is important, exercise is important, but the dog needs to be literally, there has to be a world-rocking punisher applied to that dog when it tries to bite you. It's life or death, meaning the dog's going to die if you don't stop it. And for all the snowflakes out there saying, I would never do that, I would hope you would. Let's talk about a dog biting your child in the face, your folks in the face, your grandmother in the face, you in the face, intentionally, not by accident. Sorry. You just lost the right to walk on the face of the earth. Like, guys, like, we can't have face-biting dogs in our homes. No, we can't. We have a dog with us right now. If we don't stop it, it's dead. Literally. If we don't stop the dog from biting, it will die. Now, that doesn't give us permission to be mean to the dog, but there's nothing that we won't do. We're trying to save the dog's life. So, I mean, I think people have to really remember, and I've had to put some of my personal dogs down. I've acquired dogs through the years. I had to put down 3 dogs one time, not all at once, but I put down 3 dogs because their level, their behavior did not get up to an acceptable form to live in my home or anybody's home, in my opinion. So they can't, I can't have them alive anymore. It's just the way it is. It's the way the world works. And I don't believe we should put down every aggressive dog. I believe every dog deserves a chance from a competent rehabber, trainer, someone that specializes in it. But at some point, no, we're done. It's funny how for health, we'll do it. But for behavior, we struggle. Right? I'm not talking about, oh, a dog barks too much, or a dog pulls on the leash, or it jumps, or has separation anxiety. I'm talking about a dog that can't make the right choice where it puts its mouth. It's the way it is. And I'm sure this is going to piss off a bunch of people. But when you see the horrors that I've seen, no way. Next.
This one's from Jessica.
Hey, Jessica.
When family comes over, my puppy is getting overexcited and he will potty on the floor. He also does not listen to commands when excited. Advice?
And when you get drunk, you get stupid. You might not drink. I've been sober for years, so it's not like you personally get drunk. When someone gets drunk or on drugs, they don't listen either. So when someone's overexcited, they don't listen. You have to learn how to eliminate arousal. A bonker or a good leash correction is good for that. Next.
Patrick says your show is awesome.
Thank you, Patrick.
Sarah, horse whips work great for turning a rushing dog away.
Sarah, thank you. You can use a stockyard whip. That works really, really great too. Mm-hmm. Next.
I just lost it. Okay. Doug.
Yep.
Can a dog be too attached to you? My dog can be very protective of me.
Okay. That's not attachment. We don't want your dog to be protective of you because nobody's trying to hurt you. And your dog's going to end up biting like somebody coming up to say hi, or a relative, or a delivery person. Nobody, your dog doesn't need to be protecting you. And if it does, you should have a highly trained protection dog, and they wouldn't be protective of you because they wouldn't need to be. Next.
Tiffany wants to know, have you ever had a dog that you had success with during a board and train, but the owner did not have the same success as a handler? How do you go about addressing handler issues with your clients?
Tiffany, all the time. But that's the art of what we do. Tiffany, you should be more than 50% of your training should be owner skills. Like, that's why we use tools. Because the owners are not trainers. The owners need as much leverage as possible. And the biggest problem with trainers these days is that it's based on their ego of how good of a trainer they are. Big deal. You can train a dog. That's what you do for a living. That's your career. It's not your dog. How well can the owner do? It's your job to train them. An owner will never do as well as you. They're not dog trainers. I remember, I've got a client that's a brain surgeon. Like, he's got a lot of other things on his plate besides dog training. He just wants his dog trained and his dog to listen. He's a brain surgeon, though. I can't give him too much of a hard time about a lot of stuff. I do, though, because, that's my job. But I'm saying is, people have lives. They've got kids. They've got careers. They've got a life. They want their dogs to listen. That's why we like tools. So it's your job to train the dog and then transfer that training to the owner without them working with hundreds or thousands of dogs and being as knowledgeable as you. Next.
Marnie Cool Dog. Oh, yay. You're coming to Cali and Reno. Can't wait.
Yes.
Joey, Jeff, you rock. Keep loving those haters. I am a canine trainer too and would love to come work for you.
Yeah, well, I'm easy to get a hold of. Thanks, Joey.
Angie B, would you know of a good trainer in the Killeen, Fort Hood area in Texas?
Look up James Ham. James Ham, Lone Star Dog Training. Next.
Jillian, Jeff, I live in the country, so I want my dog to alert when someone comes to the house. Do I train to stop barking when asked or not to bark, then teach to bark when someone comes to the door?
Train your dog to stop barking when the gun goes off. Got it? Yeah. Train your dog to stop barking when you tell it to quiet. Next.
This one's from Sammy.
Hold on. One more thing. Get at the end of your driveway, get yourself an alarm system that's hooked up to a doorbell in your house. It's done with a just a like an invisible laser and a little reflector. Get one of those. It's a driveway alarm. Next. Or you can do a pressure plate. Next.
Sammy, it was great talking to you today. Bonkers working already. Amazing.
Sammy, love you. Thanks.
Max Asina, if I bonk my dog, won't he become afraid of me? I do have my dog in obedience class. We use prong collars. They say never hit your dog.
Okay. So that's a common thing. Like, will your dog be afraid of you? So never hit your dog. Well, we're not hitting our dogs. First of all, you're being lied to in your class, just to let you know. Like, I've hit my dogs. I've smacked my dogs on the ass. I've smacked my dog on the snout. Like, my dogs aren't afraid of me. But your dog won't be afraid of you because you're not mad at your dog. Your dog will be afraid of doing what it was doing, and it'll stop. Fear is a powerful motivator. Fear is a powerful motivator. So I spank Angelo. He's my six-year-old son. I use this hand to spank him. And I use this hand to fist bump him. I use this hand to pick him up. I use this hand to give him a little bit of a head tossle. I use this hand to rub his back. And he's not afraid of this hand. And he's not afraid of me. My dogs are not afraid of me. So this, it's anger that people don't understand. Don't be angry at your dog. You're not angry. You're not mad. It's a matter of fact. I don't agree with what you just did. A bonker is probably the best punisher out there. Better than a remote collar in many applications. And some things you want your dog to be afraid of. Like, if you ever put your mouth on me, you better be afraid of the consequence. Absolutely. Like, guys, fear is a powerful motivator. But my dogs don't walk around in fear. We have to listen to the narrative. Next.
Okay. I think this kind of skipped up a little bit.
Kevin. Love watching your videos.
Trying to correct my dog's whining in the crate with Ecollar. Her working level is around 4 to 5. I've heard correct high. Can you give me an example of what that looks like?
Kevin, correct at the right level. Figure out what level it is and correct at it. Have your dog in a down, kennel up, lie down. Any whining, you're going to do something called fishing. So you're going to do, is it momentary? Is it continuous? Is it low? Is it high? Do you dial up? Do you dial down? Do you tap? Do you hold down? You'll have to figure it out. You got to figure out the sequence. Next.
Tiffany, do you know any good trainers in Oklahoma?
Not off the top of my head.
Sammy, do you think when a dog humps another dog, it's domineering behavior? Or as I've heard other trainers say, it's not dominance. It could be some sexual arousal or play.
Three trainers have three answers. It's called unacceptable. Stop it. Next.
Angie B says, thank you, but I'll stick with your free content and hopefully Skype soon. I know James. You guys are amazing.
Awesome. Cool.
Lorena. Bonking won't cause aggression. Same child that went for my face gets bonked and lays at my feet calmly instead of a dumb decision.
Yep.
Jeff, I can't Skype. Too expensive. Seminar is better value. 2019, maybe.
Seminar is a much better value. Here's a great example. Did everybody? I was going to do a live on this. Did everybody see the deaf dog working with Joelle? Has everybody seen that deaf dog working with Joelle? It's a white dog that is deaf. There's about a 1-minute video of a deaf dog working with Joelle on obedience on day one. Find it on Facebook or find it on Instagram. I forgot what it was. Guess what happened 3 minutes prior to that? 3 minutes prior to that. That dog got bonked. Does that dog look afraid of Joelle? On day one of training, that dog got bonked because it was too aroused. I would challenge anybody to say that dog was showing any fear of her whatsoever. And it's deaf. I'm going to be doing a live on that because it's like there's so much misinformation. When you properly know how to apply punishment, you don't have all these shrapnel effects. Do you know how many fearful dogs that we get into our training center? Owners have never bonked them. They're still fearful. Next.
Sammy, love you back. Also, where can I find more info about the leggings and stuff? Is it just leggings or are there other things too, Linda? They sound great. There's no leggings anymore. I actually sell makeup. It's been a while since I sold leggings. Actually, almost 2 years, I think.
But you can find someone that works for what company?
I guess LuLaRoe.
LuLaRoe. You can find someone that works for LuLaRoe next.
Yeah, I don't know anyone personally, yep. though. Melissa says, Lorena, have you thought about becoming a patron on Jeff's Patreon? And she puts a link to that.
Nice.
Yazarino, I'm fostering a dog that has bit a person before and was severely abused and beat daily. Do you have any advice? I've rehabilitated my own dog through your free content.
So tons of advice. But number one, how do you know it was abused and beat daily? Do you have video proof? Do you have video proof that it was beat daily? Have you seen the video of it being beaten? And I only say this because it could be a made up story and it just keeps getting duplicated. So this is what I want you to do. Yazarino 101. I never want you to repeat that again. Got it? I want you to wipe that phrase out of your description of that dog. It's gone. So you've got a dog that's what? Fearful. You have a dog that's nervous. You've got a dog that's not obedient. You've got a dog that has bitten. But I don't want you to ever repeat that it was abused ever again. Wipe it clean. That memory is gone. Because if you keep holding on to that, it will affect your success of rehabbing the dog. So what do? Put the dog through my program, just like you did with your other dogs. Next.
Horror Queen. Know any great dog trainers in Indianapolis?
No, guys, I barely know any trainers out there that I would recommend. I don't know many trainers out there at all. Colleen just hit me because I've driven through there and I know James is from there. Sean O'Shea, and I know he's in California, New Orleans, and there's Florida. But I don't recommend many trainers. I don't recommend many trainers out there because I haven't seen them do work. Next.
Iska Bigsky, Pearl. White deaf dog is Pearl.
Yep.
Cheryl, yes, can't wait to follow her story. Always looking to see what hand signs people use.
Yep. And remember, the hand signs are just, you can make up any hand sign you want to. You can make up any hand sign you want to. They have zero value until the training is in place anyway. Next.
One Purpose says, hey, Linda and Jeff, great video of the deaf dog.
Yep, exactly. And that dog was highly punished right before the video. Go figure. Next.
Oh, sorry. Yep. Lil Mama Mud with commands. Can hand signals help with the selective hearing? He follows the hand signals, but needs stim on the command still. He isn't deaf. I don't mind doing both.
No. The selective hearing is lack of punishment for known commands. That's what that is. Next.
Hi, Linda. My name is pronounced Iska Big. I don't know if it's Sky or Ski, though.
I ski big sky. So okay. Someone that actually skis off big mountains, probably.
Okay. I get it now. Cheryl, my deaf dog has selective eye contact when he doesn't want to listen.
Okay. So apply a punisher. Next.
Chevy says, great to see you, Linda. Great to see you too, Chevy.
Hey, Chevy. How are you, buddy? How's the artist going? Next.
That's it. I'm sure more's coming.
You can go to rvdogtrainer.com, but you can go to Jeff Gellman Seminars. We're rebranding my seminars now. So Jeff Gellman Seminars. I'm actually looking at a brand new RV tomorrow, guys. I'm actually going to, I'll Instagram story it. Yeah, I'll Instagram story it. So I'm looking at a new RV tomorrow, taking Romy with me. Romy's one of my daughters. And we're going to be looking at two different models, definitely. And I'm sure they'll have other Class Cs there. But this spring, I'll be driving a new rig, 2019, baby.
Am I going to want to get back in the RV?
I hope so. It's going to have a slide. It's going to have slide outs. It'll be nicer.
We'll see.
There won't be dogs all over the place because we'll have bunk beds. The dogs will be in the bunk beds.
I got kids in school now.
Yeah, you can't.
I can't.
Next.
Boo, boo, boo.
Big Sky is Montana. Next.
Huh? What are you talking about?
Next.
You're confusing me.
I'm just reading down the questions.
Okay, please don't do that. Yes. That's confusing to me. David, I always use my own hand signals because I don't want others who think they know how to talk to my dog. LOL.
David's got a secret. David does secret handshakes with his dogs. Next.
Oh, Sarah says Big Sky equals Montana.
Got it.
Okay. Angie B, I'm sorry. I did not mean to put you in a recommending other trainer spot.
Angie, I could have said no. I didn't know. Don't worry about it.
I ski Big Sky. Sarah, yes.
Exactly.
I said it right.
And they have forests out there too. Next.
Tiffany, I've been following your other daughter on Instagram who makes knives. Wow.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Guys, follow her now. Follow her now. Because she's going to be on TV. Okay? She's going to be making it huge. Like, real huge. And you guys can guess what TV show she's going to be on. She's a knife maker.
And it's not Say Yes to the Dress.
No, okay? She's a badass motherfucker. She is a badass. When she was 12 years old, she's a knife maker. She was 12 years old. She was taking the city bus. So we have a city bus. We have a bus stop right outside of us. We live in Providence in the city. Some guy was driving around, you know, driving around the neighborhood, slowing down. Kept driving around, slowing down at her and her sister. 12 years old. Guy slows down, rolls down her window.
His window.
She walks over to the car and she goes, "If you stop one more time, I'll cut you." She was 12.
Yeah, and she had our steak knives in her purse.
Yes. She's 28 and a knife maker now. She's a badass. She's a badass. I just went and visited her. Just delivered that damn truck to her. Next. Next.
I'm sorry.
It's like, it's like Tourette's.
You're getting a little out of control tonight. Are you ready?
I'm afraid to say next.
You shouldn't say anything.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yazzarino, thank you. That phrase is officially erased from my vocabulary.
Good. Proud of you.
Marnie Cool Dog says, yeah, Linda, Rev. I don't know what that means. I'm not sure what we're doing. Lorena, will you spoil me with any stories of chows you've worked with? I've never seen a balanced trainer work with one. It would be so encouraging to keep at it.
So Lorena, a chow, chows can be challenging. But I've worked with chows and to us, it's all the same. It's all the same. You've got a biting dog. What happened?
This all of a sudden popped up. It's trying to scan my computer right now.
Okay. All right.
And it won't let me do it.
All right. We're almost done with the show. So
I can't read anything else.
Sammy, go to your phone.
My phone's downstairs.
So go get your phone. Okay. I'll hold the ship down.
What the hell is
here? Just read from here.
I can't.
Okay. What kind of, Sammy says, what kind of makeup do you sell and where can I see? Sammy, you're going to go to, what's your Facebook page?
Well, it's complicated.
Okay.
Is Sammy on Facebook?
Yes.
Message me.
So message Linda Gellman. Just go to Linda Gellman. All right. I want to go to Collingwood, need a bride, still trying to work it out, trying to bribe my brother with a free holiday. Yeah. Get up to Collingwood. It's going to be a fun seminar. It's a lot of fun. Forest, LOL, the woods. Chevy, unfortunately, I'm painting my house to sell. I wish it was for... Oh, Chevy, I thought when you were talking about painting, I thought you were doing art. So, I mean, painting your house is art, I guess. Tiffany says, yes, she is. I'm probably talking about my daughter, Olivia. She's a badass. Angie B says, yes, she is. Greg, and now she makes knives. Yes, I know. Now she makes knives. Tiffany, I saw her shave her legs with whatever knife she made. I was like, holy fuck. So she'll take a knife that she makes and she'll cut. She'll cut wood. Can you turn that down?
She'll cut wood.
She'll cut wood with it and then literally cut right through paper. Ross, I love watching her work. It's amazing. She's so talented. You know where we are?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Tiffany G, next.
Part one, foster dog attacked my dog upon entering the room. I thought it was food aggression originally because food bowl was out. Now I always feed them in crates.
Smart.
Part two, foster dog went after dog again the other day upon other dog entering the room. No food out. Could this be resource guarding me?
Could be. So Tiffany, if you don't have experience with aggression, send the dog back. Got it? It's not fair to your other dog. So if you don't have a high level of experience with dog-on-dog aggression, send the dog back. And whatever happens, happens. Your current dog shouldn't be penalized because of your kind heart. And you shouldn't end up in the emergency room breaking up a dog fight. This could fuck up your current dog for the rest of its life. Next.
One purpose. Jeff, my GSD has been jumping this tall bank in my backyard for 4 months. This is part of our daily work. Yesterday, he missed the bank twice and he didn't want to try to jump anymore. Work him through it.
If you want him to keep doing it, put him on a leash and work him through it. Also, just make sure he's not injured. Next.
Tammy, found the Petaluma seminar. Just have to figure out lodging. Would love to attend a seminar.
Yeah, well, lodging, just jump on it. I don't even know where I'm staying. Just jump on Airbnb. There's plenty of places. Jump on Airbnb or Expedia. Next.
Susan says, don't scan, Linda. It's maybe a virus. Oh, it's probably a virus.
It is a virus.
And I didn't voluntarily start the scan.
Right, yep.
It started on its own. All right, Sarah. Pretty sure there are videos of Jeff and his staff working a black chow.
Yeah. But guys, it doesn't make a difference if it's a chow, a pit bull, a German shepherd, a Rottweiler, or a Doberman. It really doesn't. It doesn't. Next.
Cotton flower. I'm becoming hopeless with my GSD. I swear I get the e-collar correction timed right every time we pass a dog, and I praised when he ignored them, and I've seen no progress. He's always just as reactive as usual. I can't afford a trainer, and I don't understand what I'm doing wrong.
So I have to see you actually work the dog, Cottonflower. I'd have to see you work the dog. But there has to be, the thing is that timing has a lot to do with it. You might be too close to the other dog. You might be not correcting early enough. Your dog might be in an aroused state the whole time. So you need to eliminate the arousal before you even go for a walk. But if you're not seeing progress, then something you're doing is not right. So don't get frustrated. We're gonna have to change it up for you. Next.
Sammy Shipman says, oh, LOL, okay, thanks. Susan, shut the, okay, it's all, it actually, I just fixed it. Thanks, Susan. Tiffany, two Tiffanys, WTF.
Yep.
Angie B, I'm switching from the Garmin because of the educator's boost feature.
Because the educator's, yeah.
And my timing is not great yet.
Yeah, I mean, timing is important. Next.
I don't have anything.
Okay. We're over an hour anyway. So this is the thing. It's time for us to come to a close. Monday we do an hour show. It's already 10 p.m. I still have a couple hours of work to do ahead of me. I got to call John out in California still. I've got one business consult I still got to do tonight. That's what I do for a living. I do business consults mostly. I help people grow their business and troubleshoot business issues. Jeff Gellman seminars, we're doing about 20 of them in 2019. So go there, see which ones we're launching, see which ones we've already got. I talked to Tucson earlier today. We might do something in Tucson. I'm really looking for someplace in, someplace in Asia to do something, to do a seminar. Somebody from New Zealand contacted me today. I'd have to line that up with an Australian seminar, I think. Unless I can do that one in Singapore, I can do it. I've got a trainer colleague in Singapore, do one in Singapore, then fly down to New Zealand. That makes sense logistically. check out our Instagram. There's a lot of stuff, great stuff going on Instagram as well. Just go to solidcaninetraining.com, see everything we're doing. I want to just thank everybody, and I really, really appreciate the time, and I appreciate all the hard work everyone's doing. And if you're frustrated, like who is frustrated tonight? Somebody flower.
Cottonflower.
Cottonflower too. You know, I mean, dogs can be frustrating. You know, dogs can be frustrating. And a lot of times people think they're doing something right and it needs to be tweaked. A lot of times people think they're cutting down on affection, but it's still way too much affection. I try to give out as much free information as I possibly can through videos, through spoken word, through, you know, well, those are the two things. I don't do blog posts. My buddy Sean O'Shea does a great blog post. So I want to just, everybody's doing really, really well. I will see you all on Wednesday night before Thanksgiving. So if you're in the United States and you celebrate Thanksgiving, happy Thanksgiving if I don't talk to you. If you're in Canada or another country, it's one of our holidays here. But we have a worldwide audience.